name's David Arellano. It has a name, it's Gumball. Ex-girlfriend came over to my house, she left a packet of gumballs there, and that's where the name came from. It's a 2000 Subaru Impreza 2.5 RS. It's a 2004 WRX engine, VF39, STI turbo, STI injectors, STI top mount, NVIDIA downpipe, K&N intake, manual boost controller. I actually bought the car swapped, but I spent a lot of time looking for a car that was already swapped or finding one that I could swap myself, but realized it just wasn't going to be worth my time. So the car makes 280 wheel horsepower, right around 240 foot-pounds of torque. It makes good power and the car is lighter with shorter gears, so it really makes it a fun car to drive. The shop that actually swapped it is out of business now. We won't mention their name for their own good. She went a full year with essentially the wrong transmission. So it seized up, the car totally stopped, which really caused a lot of headaches for me. You know, this car has actually been pretty great aside from issues that came up from there. There's a lot of little bits and pieces that you wouldn't really realize are there unless you sat in a stock car. One of the key items is the Japanese seats. You know, they're JDM STI, version 6, spec C, R limited. They're extremely rare. You know, they only came in something like 600 cars over in Japan. So to have them here and in my car is definitely something I'm really, really happy about. JDM steering wheel, I have STI floor mats, I have black carpet swapped out suede door cards, the JDM STI aluminum polished pedals that are super rare, I've actually only come across two of them, LED converted cluster, nobody's gonna really see, except for me on a daily basis, but for me it's a really cool thing that I can get in my car and say this is different, this is unique. So the front lip, it's a really, really, really special item. I think it's probably the rarest thing on the car, considering this is one of two in the United States, even though it's on one of the lowest GCs. Desmond Super Longchamp XR3s, they're wild, they're crazy, they're different, they're unique, something that you don't see every day. The wheels really set it off. These in particular are very, very rare. It's actually one of maybe three sets I've ever seen to exist at all. Now, when I saw them on the classifieds page, I had to go for them. 17 by 9 plus 15, which is really aggressive for this car. Fitting them up itself was actually quite the challenge. I had to slot my coilovers for enough camber to clear them. But on top of that, I also had to trim my studs to clear the 4 lug and 5 lug. On top of that, I have a 15 millimeter adapter, making them an effective zero offset. Wheels are like a new haircut. You know, they totally change the image of the car. The first set of real wheels, I guess you could say, I've ever had was a set of Volt C28, set of SSR Competitions, to a set of Work Emotion 11Rs, my set of Desmond Rega Masters, one of my all-time dream wheels, but they're really hard to find. They're incredibly rare, they're only getting rarer. In between, I've had many sets of wheels. Also had a set of 5Ziggen FN01Rs, currently have a set of Impul RSs that are very, very rare as well. Wheels are just, that's what I do. Changing up wheels on your car makes all the difference. It makes a whole new image. Work, I do photography. It's all automotive photography, nightlife photography. You know, my dad growing up, he always worked on cars. Eventually I got into photography, and of course naturally I was bound to start taking pictures of cars. That's where it really started. The car itself is a piece of art. You know, each car has its own story to tell in a way, and I just love capturing vehicles. It's a big passion of mine, just like the car is. It's a really fun car to drive. It's different, it's definitely a challenge, because of the height, but I mean, at the same time, it makes it look so crazy, it's so wild. I've been driving it for 4 years every single day, and it'd be weird for me to drive anything else. I mean, I think it's really just a summary of all the parts combined. You have to really make it a combination and make it a true piece of art. You know, it all needs to be cohesive and make sense. It's still a really fun car to drive, and I love it just because it's unique and it just brakes nice.